नमस्ते, वेलकम टू दिस सेशन विद विद्या नाहर. प्लीज कंसल्ट योर फिजिशियन टू एंश्योर द सुटेबिलिटी ऑफ द एक्सरसाइजेस इन द फॉलोइंग वीडियो फॉर योर स्पेसिफिक नीड्स. द क्रिएटर्स एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स ऑफ दिस वीडियो आर नॉट रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर एनी इंजुरीज और डैमेजेस कॉज टू यू बाय फॉलोइंग द एक्सरसाइजेस डेमॉन्स्ट्रेटेड इन दिस वीडियो. थैंक यू फॉर योर इंटरेस्ट. Good luck and best wishes. Please keep up your breath and posture awareness throughout this practice. Sit upright and tall. Bring your awareness to the place that you are occupying right now, keeping your eyes closed. We're going to practice Yin Yoga, which is good for flexibility, not so much for strength, but it allows you to move your muscles in different directions. We often neglect the joints at the cost of muscles. We focus so much on muscles. So this practice is going to focus mainly on joints that allow you the increased range of motion. And holding poses longer reaches more into your bones, connecting tissues, your body structure, and not at superficial level of muscles. So with your eyes closed, sitting upright and tall, just put more pressure on your right foot, press it down firmly. Feel this activation in your entire right leg as you're pressing the right edge of your right foot down. Relax, let go. Press the left edge of your left foot down firmly. And notice this activation in your entire left leg all the way up to your hip. Nothing in the body works by itself. Everything is connected to somewhere else, just like we are all independent and interdependent. Relax, let go. Now protrude your right sit bone firmly down. When somebody sits in your lap, you feel the bony protrusion. So similarly, protrude your right sit bone into the mat, making it intentionally heavier. While your left sit bone is still on the floor, you feel all of your weight on your right sit bone, activating the right side of the body. Relax, let go. Put that pressure on your left sit bone. Again, press it down firmly. This simple act of pressing down more is bringing more blood, energy, oxygen, awareness to that left sit bone, left side of the body. No tension anywhere else. Relax, let go. Now squeeze your both kneecaps as if you are squishing a pillow behind your kneecaps. This will activate your hamstrings, your calves. Relax, let go. Press your both thighs upwards towards your palms like you are firming up your thighs for a blow from outside. And relax, let go. Bring your awareness to your mid region, stomach, lower back, hips, glutes, urinary tract muscles, kegel muscles, anal muscles. Squeeze everything in tightly, again like you are firming up for a blow from outside on your belly. Keep tightening everything in the mid region. So you're feeling this intentional tension and relaxation just to see the difference knowingly between the two states. And relax, let go. So feeling your weight equally distributed on both sit bones, keep sitting upright and tall. Press your both shoulders towards the floor. Just press them down away from your ears, at the same time reaching up through the crown of your head. If somebody sees you from outside, not much is happening. But you know you are changing the intention of the pose by shifting your weight, your awareness. Just keep pressing the shoulders down almost to the point of being painful. Feel this heavy weight on your shoulders. And relax, let go. Now freeze your neck muscles as if you cannot move your head in any direction. Just keep tightening, and again, if it happens in real life, it can be very painful. So just simulating that state
gives you an idea how it feels and gives you more control and more ways to prevent it. And then soften the neck muscles. So anytime you're doing this conscious contraction and relaxation, it's keeping those muscles active, bringing more blood, energy, oxygen there. Now close your eyes as tightly as you can. Feel these wrinkles in your forehead, tension in your eyes, eyebrows, space between eyebrows. Keep tightening your eyes even more, just when it feels you cannot shut them any tighter, you can. And shut them even tighter. You're also simulating the tear glands. As we grow older, tear glands start drying up, so you're stimulating these tear glands. You may feel some watering in the eyes, that's just natural cleansing of your eyes. Slowly soften your eyes, keeping your eyes closed if possible. Body relaxed. Move your awareness from your body to your breath. As you exhale, you draw the stomach in, like a balloon becoming smaller with outgoing air. And as you inhale, let the stomach relax, like a balloon becoming bigger with incoming air. Let the incoming air do the job of filling your belly up. You don't need to push the stomach out. You just focus on contracting with your exhale. This contraction and expansion happens at your navel center, at your diaphragm. Diaphragm is the muscle, dome-shaped muscle that separates your chest and abdominal cavities. So if you let your diaphragm flatten with incoming air, because the air is putting pressure on that dome-shaped muscle, you'll find your ribcage expanding. And when the air goes out, that dome opens up again, dome of your diaphragm, and you are able to draw the stomach in. So follow this rhythmic movement of the body in and out at your belly button and not up and down at your chest. So minimize the chest breathing and maximize the diaphragmatic breathing. Not just here in the yoga practice, on your yoga mat, throughout your day, keep coming back to this breath. Exhale, you draw the stomach in. Inhale, you relax the stomach. This also supports your lower back region, because your lower back has no muscles. The core muscles are all in the front in your stomach, especially your transverse abdominals. When you contract and relax your muscles, abdominal muscles, in every single breath, you are strengthening your core muscles in every breath. So you don't need to get on your mat to do those abdominal crunches. If you can simply contract your stomach in each exhale and relax with your inhale, that activates your digestion, your elimination, cleansing process in your core muscles. With this awareness of body and breath, invite your mind to be a part of this practice. Establish the intention of you being here today. Maybe you are here to learn something new about yourself or let go of something that has been bothering you. Or reinforce whatever you have been practicing or restore your equilibrium. Test your strengths, challenge your limitations. Spend time with like-minded people, invest time in yourself, go more inward. Or you are here because your practice allows you to feel focused, flexible, at peace with yourself, with your surroundings, relaxed, happy, healthy, de-stressed, open to new possibilities. Whatever it is, keep it at your personal level, in present tense, in positive words. So it is not for somebody else that you are setting this intent, it's for yourself. It's not for some future time, it is now and here in this moment, in this body, in this breath, in this space. And it is something that you are doing and not not doing. So this is in positive terms. And then release it. Let it happen at its own pace. Our job is just to practice. Let the universe deliver the results. We'll practice eye muscle stretches. Before that, just simply switch your legs. So bring the inside leg out. If sitting like this on the floor for a long time is too much, you can also sit on a chair, or you may sit upon the block that allows you to support your lower back, and you can sit up a little bit taller also. So feel free to provide this cushion for yourself. And again, as we are going to hold the stretches longer, same goes with the eye muscle stretches. So without turning your head, look all the way to your right, as far out to the right as you can. If you have a window on your right side, look out the window and focus at a point. Continue breathing evenly. Exhale as you draw the stomach in. Inhale, you relax the stomach. You're stretching your peripheral vision. Just like any other muscle in the body, your eye muscles need stretching. These are the most overutilized muscles in the body. We keep them glued to screens in front of us. So mostly activating frontal vision, and we forget this peripheral vision. Look all the way to your left side and again hold your gaze steady. Notice if there's a difference between the two sides of your eye muscles. Are you able to stretch your eyes about the same angle on this side that you did on the other side? Just observe. Nothing that's being observed goes unaffected by the observer. In this case, you are the observer, you are the observed. So not just doing it, but also noticing it, seeing it. Like you are a third person watching yourself, what you are doing. Back to the center and look all the way up towards the ceiling, just the eyes. Continue breathing. Exhale, stomach in. Inhale, relax the stomach. Same even diaphragmatic breath, whether you are resting, stretching, doing your job, driving your car. Come back to your breath throughout your day. And drop your gaze towards the floor. You may do all these stretches with your eyes closed also. That simulates your deep sleep state. Look straight ahead in front of you, as far in the front as you can see. And again, if you feel watering in your eyes, that's okay. That's natural cleansing of your eyes. If you need to blink your eyes, blink and come back to that same focal point. And exhale to the tip of your nose. Take your gaze between your two eyebrows at your third eye center, intuition center, with your eyes open or closed. Focus between your two eyebrows. This third eye opens on the inside. When your two eyes are open, you are focused on the external world. When you close those external eyes, you have more opportunity to open your third eye within, go inward, see the light inside. We often seek guidance, feedback from outside, forgetting to go within. So these two eyes like a toggle switch. If you open the eyes, your awareness is outside of you. If you close your eyes consciously, not falling asleep, your awareness is more inward. Practice this conscious inward awareness every day, even if it's for 2, 3, 5 minutes. With your eyes open or closed, slowly turn your head towards your right. Feel the stretch in the left side of your neck. Keep your shoulders relaxed. Remember to breathe. Exhale. exhale, stomach in, inhale, relax the stomach. If there are other thoughts, let them come and go. Just keep coming back to your breath. The more you close your eyes and connect with your breath, the more each pose becomes meditative. Come back to the center. Turn your head towards your left. Feel the stretch in the right side of your neck. Keep breathing. Releasing the tension from your work, driving, wrong sleeping position, lifting weights, talking on phone, watching TV. Whatever puts a repetitive stress on your neck, sister, time to let it all go. Come back to the center. Drop right ear to right shoulder. With right hand, pull your head down. Walk your left hand away from you. Feel the stretch in the left side of your neck. If your eyes are open, look at a point on the ceiling. If your eyes are closed, focus between your two eyebrows. As you're holding your stretch, don't hold your breath. Back to the center, drop left ear to left shoulder. With left hand, pull your head down. Walk your right hand away from you, stretches in the right side of your neck. Back to the center. Take your both hands behind you. And if you're sitting on the block, come on the floor, put your feet together. Knees apart and walk your hands as back as you can. I'll show you from the side. You can stay where you are. So simply walking your hands away from you, drop your head back. So you're opening your throat, compressing your neck, at the same time opening your heart. Keep walking your fingers away from you, tightening your upper back, opening your chest. Remember to breathe. Hold it there. Keep pressing your knees towards the floor. If you sit a lot in your chairs, walk, jog, bicycle, dance. It's a good openness for your hips. This is opening your heart center, making more room for your respiratory organs, your lungs, your chest muscles, your pectorals. Now walk your hands slowly towards the front. All the way, take them as forward as you can, and then bring your chin to the throat. So keep the back straight, don't round the back. Back is straight. You may also place the block in the front and just press the chin to the throat first. Your hands may be down here or up here, or you can just simply keep them here, but just press your chin to the throat. Wherever you can, press the chin down. So this is now stretching the root of your neck, compressing your throat. Continue breathing. Holding poses longer gives you more time to register each pose at a deeper level, gives your body more time to register the feedback. So notice if there's any discomfort at the root of your neck here. If you're feeling it in your chest, upper back, shoulders, they're all connected. Slowly roll your head up towards your right with your inhale. Make it a slow, thorough, deep neck rotation down towards your left with your exhale. Finish to the center. Reverse, take it up towards your left with your inhale. And down towards your right with your exhale. I'm going to face you. You can stay where you are. From here, bring your right hand to the left knee and left hand goes over to the right side. So I'm doing your mirroring. Look towards the ceiling to the left side. Hold it there. Continue breathing. Keep pressing your knees down. Feel the stretch from your hip all the way to the shoulder, to your elbow, to your fingertips. This is your side body stretch. Separating your side vertebrae, keep pressing the left knee down with your right hand and reach over with your left hand. Breathe into each of these poses. So breathe in those side vertebrae right now. Keep your focus fully of that left side of the trunk right now. And bring your left hand behind you. Look back to the left side. Keep your trunk upright and just add a simple twist. Press this left palm down. So I'll show you again from the side. And bring it closer to you. So the closer you bring it, the taller you can sit. So instead of leaning on that hand, bring it in. And you straighten up your trunk with the support of the arm, like you're propping your body up by pulling the arm in. At the same time, the more you press your right palm into the left thigh, the more you can turn to the left side. So activate the pressure on the opposite hand. So your right hand is applying the pressure as you turn more to the left. Now slowly as you face front, this right knee, drop it towards your left foot. So now you are internally rotating your hip. Keep your left thigh parallel to this short edge of your mat. So think of a right angle here. Your left heel to the right knee in line with your ankle, hip. So it's almost like a square here. And then you turn your body to the left. Bring your forearms to the floor to the left. Look to the left side. Hold it there. So your left heel to the right knee, left knee to the front edge of your mat. Your entire shin is parallel to the front edge of your mat. And thigh is parallel to the short edge of the mat. And look to the left side. Now turn your body a little bit more to the left, press your right foot back more so you can look at your right foot over your left shoulder. Turn your head back so much and press your right foot back so much that you're actually seeing that foot over your shoulder. Remember to breathe. Exhale, stomach in, inhale, relax the stomach, that does not change. Slowly push yourself back up, come back up, stretch your right leg and turn your body even more to the left side, bringing your left foot in front of you, left shin in front of you, with your right leg fully stretched out and you square your hips to the left side. Hold it there, breathe, elongating your trunk. Now flex your right foot and lift your right knee off the floor. If you can bring your right hand on this left ankle, left hand on the left knee, come up into this upward facing pigeon pose. So your right knee, right heel, right hip are all off the floor and you lift your trunk, look up, hold it there. Continue breathing. You feel the stretch in your right hip flexor. Our hip flexors are like emotional dustbins of the body. We sit a lot in our chairs and they keep getting contracted, accumulating all of our stress. So it's important that we stretch those hip flexors open. Now drop that right knee, drop the top of your right foot, drop your right forearm to the floor. So this entire right side is down. Raise your left arm, look at your left arm. Hold it there, remember to breathe. Keep reaching up with your left hand towards the sky. Bend your left elbow behind your back. Bring it towards your left foot. If it doesn't reach the foot, that's okay. You may simply bring it by the ribcage and keep pressing your left shoulder up. Look towards the ceiling. Continue breathing. So again, you're adding the stretch for your neck, opener for your heart. Tightening the upper back. Keep pressing the right forearm down to lift up your trunk. So don't collapse on this right forearm. Don't go Over that arm, keep lifting your shoulder up so it's in line with your elbow. Raise your left arm, bring it down to the front, and raise your right arm, look at your right arm. So again, keep pressing this left forearm down. Don't collapse your upper body. The more you press your forearm down, the more you can lift up your chest and reach up. Look at your right hand, stretch your fingers all the way up. If your palms are not fully open, if you're cupping your palms, stretch them out like you're really reaching for the ceiling. Straight arm up perpendicular to the ceiling. Bend your right elbow behind your back, press your shoulder up, look up to the ceiling even more. Keep this right leg as straight in the back as you can. And your left forearm is down, press the left forearm down to open your chest more to the right. Continue breathing, feel this tightening in your upper back. It's all about opening your heart. Your right hand is behind you, bend your elbow behind your back so you can press your shoulder up. Then raise your right hand and bring your both hands to the front. Lower your forehead. If your forehead is not on the floor, you may again place it on the block. You can also make this block stand up and then extend your arms. So whichever way feels comfortable. If you don't have a block near you, use a cushion. Feel the stretch in your left glute, left hamstring. In your right hip flexor and the sides of your trunk, keep reaching with your arms to the front and leg to the back. Again, holding it longer. Just surrendering in this moment, in this pose. If you are feeling any resistance, any tension anywhere, feel it melting away. Make yourself comfortable in this pose. If it feels like any kind of pain, shooting pain anywhere, ease into it, ease out of that pain by adjusting your position. As you come back up slowly, lift up yourself, bend your right knee, lift your foot up, point your foot towards the sky, and again raise your left arm, take your left hand to the outer edge of your foot, pinky toe side of your foot. As you draw the foot in, let your foot equally push back in your hand, hold it there. And look back over your left shoulder towards your right foot. So it's your opposite hand to the foot. I'm doing your mirroring your left hand to the right edge of your right foot. The more you pull your foot in, the more your foot is pushing back in your hand, opening up your left shoulder. Now left hand to the floor in front of your right hand to the inner arch of your right foot. Your right foot is still up, you're just switching the hand. Right hand to the right foot, look straight ahead. Hold it there. Keep looking ahead. Again, as you draw the foot in, let your foot equally push back into the hand. Don't twist your hand like this to go on the inside of your foot. Just simply open it and take it back so that it reaches the inside of your foot. Now, those of you can bring the other hand also back, both hands back, pulling onto the foot. But if that is too much, it's okay to stay with your right hand by the foot and left hand to the front. So this can be intense for your knee. If it is hard, you can also double up your mat under the right knee or place a cushion under that right knee. So you can always make it a little bit more comfortable for your joints. Breathe. From there, slowly stretch out your right leg and now sit on your left sit bone, face front. Both arms up, inhale. And go towards your right leg, exhale. So it's now forward fold towards that right leg. If your hands are not by the foot, use your strap and then go deeper. You can pull on to that strap, look ahead and go deeper. Look ahead and go. So let your focus be toward the front and not down, because this gives you false impression if your head touches the floor. Think about going down with your chest and not with your forehead. So you keep this trunk elongated to reach forward. Feel the stretch in your right hamstring. Remember to breathe. Don't contract your neck. So it's not like this, but just a normal stretch in your neck. Breathe. Keep looking ahead towards that right foot. Remember to breathe. Keep pressing the back of your right knee towards the floor. Come back up. Bring your right hand to the left foot and left hand going down sideways towards that right foot. Look towards the left side. Continue breathing. So again, stretching the side of your trunk. Keep breathing. So if your hand is not by that foot, use your strap. As you come back up, bring your left forearm to the floor. Stretch your right leg more in line with your right hip. Put your weight on that left forearm, stretching your right arm overhead. If you can lift up your sit bone a little bit, do that. So feel that weight bearing work on that left forearm. Keep pressing the edge of your right foot down firmly. The inner edge. So you can keep reaching overhead with your right hand. Hold. If this is too much weight bearing for you, you can always remain seated and then do the same thing. Then slowly sitting up again, bring your right foot in and we're going to do everything on the other side. So just keep pulling the feet in first, sit up tall, left hand to the right knee and right hand goes to the left side. Look towards the ceiling, hold it there. Continue breathing. Keep pressing that left knee down towards the right knee. The more you press that knee down, the more you can take your body to the left. Again, breathing into this space that you're just opening up on the right side of your trunk. Stretch your right elbow. If you're bending your elbow, straighten it, that's right, keep straightening it. Reach from your hip to your shoulder, to your elbow, to your wrist, all the way to your fingertips. Now bring this right hand behind you. With your left hand, push the right knee and look to the right side. So again, I'll show you from the side. So that you bring this palm closer to you, not lean back on it, but bring it in to prop yourself up. And apply pressure with your left hand to look over your right shoulder. So do everything with awareness, with intention, with deliberate awareness. Not doing something habitually, but knowingly. Keep breathing, hold it there. As you face front, drop this left knee to the right foot and your right thigh is again parallel to the short edge of your mat and your right shin is parallel to the front edge of the mat. So again, think of like a square between your two knees and your hips and your heels, and you bring your forearms to the right side. Then you start turning your body to the right. Hold it there, feel this twist. Your forearms are down and your feet, your hips, knees are all down. Now press your left foot away from you so you can look at your left foot over your right shoulder. The more you turn your body to the right, the more you can turn your head, the more you can see that left foot. Remember to breathe. Keep pressing your forearms down to lift your trunk. Don't collapse your trunk forward on your arms. So see if you can maintain a 90 degree angle at your elbows instead of collapsing forward. As you come back up, straighten up your trunk one more time, stretch up your arms and bring your right leg all the way to the right side as you turn your body to the right side. So now your left leg is fully stretched in the back, left foot is pointing and your right shin is as parallel to the front edge of your mat as you can. Then lift up your left knee, left heel, left hand on your heel, right hand on the right knee, lift up your heart, look up to the sky. So feel this opening in your left hip flexor. Lift up towards the sky, keep breathing. Keep the shoulders relaxed down and away from your ears. If you find you're tensing up in your neck and shoulders, relax. Just like we did in the initial warm up. Press your shoulders down and away from your ears and you keep lifting your heart up. So all of this is elongating your spine, releasing this compression, especially from the lower back region. If you sit a lot in the chairs, we tend to compress the lower back a lot. That's where all the back trouble start. Relax the shoulders, 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 relax. Yes. And then lift up your trunk. So no tension. Then drop that left knee, drop the top of your left foot flat, left forearm on the floor. Raise your right arm, look at your right arm. So left forearm is pressing down to lift your trunk up to the right. Keep reaching up through your fingertips to the right. Bend your right elbow, bring your right hand towards your right foot. If your hand is not reaching the foot, that's okay. Place it behind your back wherever it reaches towards the opposite ribcage. Keep lifting your head up. The more you press your left forearm down, the more you can reach up towards the right. So again, notice this cross lateral connections in the body. Raise your right arm, bring it down to the floor in front of you. Raise your left arm, look at your left arm. Keep your focus on what you're doing, mind with your body. So literally gaze on that left middle fingertip up there. If your eyes start wandering, mind starts wandering. Focus on what you're doing. Mind, body, breath together. Bend your left elbow behind your back. Press your shoulder up. Look to the ceiling even more. So turn your upper body more to the left by applying pressure on your right forearm. But don't drop your neck into the shoulder. So if you're collapsing this neck and shoulder or tensing them up, relax. And just open your chest towards the left. Continue breathing. Feel this opening in your trunk in all directions. Raise your left arm down to the floor in the front. Both forearms to the front. Drop your forehead to the floor. If your forehead is not on the floor, use your block. And then you place your forehead on the block. If you don't have a block or cushion or anything, you can also just fold your forearms in the front. And then rest your forehead into your forearms. So several ways you can make your forehead supported here. And all of this is a matter of practice. The more you practice, the more range of motion you'll experience. If your forehead is fully down, keep walking your forearms, your arms to the front. Stretching your whole body stretches from your fingertips to your left foot, foot toe tips in the back. Stretches in your left hip flexor, right glute, right hamstring, right piriformis muscle. Make sure you have room in front of your nose to breathe through the nose. And slowly start walking your hands back towards you. As you come up to the sitting upright position, bending your left knee, raise your left foot and raise your right arm. Bring your right hand to the left outer edge of your foot. Look at your foot over your right shoulder. So as you draw the foot in, let your foot equally push back. Your right hand going back to the left foot, opposite hand to the foot. I'm doing your mirroring. Your right hand to your left foot. So listen to my words. You may even close your eyes and just follow the practice just by listening to the words. Right hand to the left foot. So focus less on seeing and focus more on listening. Seeing with eyes open is overrated. The more you close your eyes, the more you'll improve your listening capacity. Activating your ears more than your eyes. The more you pull your left foot in, keep pressing it back into that right hand. Now bring your right hand to the floor in the front, left hand to the inside of your left foot, same hand, same foot. Draw the foot in, at the same time let your foot equally push back in your hand. So hand is pulling in and foot is pushing out. This will open up this left shoulder. Look straight ahead. When you have same hand, same leg, you look ahead, don't look back. When you are ready, you may also add your right hand. So both hands in the back, and you may find one side to be different than the other. If it's not happening today, it's okay. You may keep your right hand on the floor and just leave the left hand by the left foot. Hold it there. Keep pulling the foot in. At the same time, foot is pushing back. Now if you are collapsing your head, neck on that right shoulder, stay upright. Feel this distance between your ear and your shoulder. Draw the foot in with your left hand, at the same time foot is pushing back in your hand. And slowly let go. Face front, right heel in the perineum, left leg straight out, keep your foot flexed. If you're going to use the strap, bring it to the left side. You may also use the block. Raise your both arms, turn towards that left foot with your exhale. So if your hands are not by the foot, you may also place them on the block. Or if you have your strap or scarf or towel, reach around the foot with your strap. First, straighten your trunk. So lengthen this lower back and don't round. If somehow to reach the foot, you are rounding the back, it's not doing any good to you. First lift up, lengthen, and you hinge at your hip. Look ahead and let your chin lead you down, not your forehead. So look ahead and go down. Look ahead and go down. You can feel the stretch in your hamstring. Look ahead and go deeper. Hold it there. Remember to breathe. Exhale, stomach in. Inhale, relax the stomach. Keep pressing the back of that left knee down to the floor. Walk your hands back towards you, both arms up. Left hand to the right knee and right hand going sideways towards that left foot. So if it doesn't reach the foot, again, strap is your friend. You can walk your hands on the strap towards that foot. And keep looking towards the ceiling to the right side. So again, opening of your hips, inner thighs, grow in area in all different directions. Keep reaching lower. Breathe. Feel this separation between the side vertebrae on the right side of your trunk. You often forget to stretch the sides of the body. Remember, you can use the block also here. By placing your block on your foot or on the floor and then reaching for the block. Raise your right arm one more time, bring it down to the floor to the right side, stretch your left leg. Left arm overhead. If you need to remain seated, that's okay. If you can lift up your sit bones, do that and hold this weight on your right forearm. Again, don't collapse your neck, shoulders. Keep pressing the forearm down to lift up your trunk and lift up your head away from your shoulder. Feel the stretch from your left big toe to your knee, to your hip, to your shoulder, to your elbow, to your fingertips. Reach, stretch your elbow. Don't bend your elbow, straighter. Straight line from your heel to your fingertips. And slowly sitting down, come up to the sitting upright position one more time. Both feet to the front again. Hold it there, breathe. So from here, again relaxing your shoulders, open both legs. As wide, as open as you can. Feel this inner thigh stretch. Keep your feet flexed. So this is called flexing, when you narrow the angle of the joint, and this is pointing. And we do pointing and flexing quite often, so it's important for you to know. This is flexing. This stretches the backs of your legs. When you point, it stretches the tops of your legs and the fronts of your legs. So from here, both arms up one more time. Lift up. Keep stretching your legs wide open, and you reach up from your hips to your shoulders to your elbows and add a forward fold with your exhale. If you can go only halfway here by keeping your trunk long, that's okay. Stay here. If you can go deeper without rounding the back, again you may place your block in the front. I'm just going to go a little bit more back so you can see better. And just go all the way. You can do this or walk your hands forward wherever you can. If your hands are not on the floor, that's okay, but keep the back straight, so don't round your back. And once you are there, bring your hands towards your inner arches of the feet and then go even deeper. Again, this is all a matter of practice, so keep pressing your hands. Your hands may be here, or your hands may be by your inner thigh, just pushing those legs wide open, applying your own body's pressure. If you can go deeper, go deeper. I'll show this again from the side. So you can see the elongation in the spine. First you keep the leg straight and back straight, and you hinge at your hip. So think of this longness in your back, hinging at the hip, not rounding. So it's not somehow reaching forward, but you first you elongate, and then you can reach as far out as you can, pushing the legs away from inside out. Breathe. Walk your hands up one more time. Now this time, bring your feet a bit closer, bending your knees. First I'll show you from the side and then I'll face you, but you can stay where you are. We're going to practice our turtle stretch or Kurmasana. So take your hands from inside out of your leg like this. So this is called internal rotation. This is external. When we are reaching back, we were externally opening. Now you bring it in, rotate inward, and take your hands from inside out. So both hands go from inside out. So if they're not all the way back, they could be just this way, and that's okay. Wherever you can go from inside out. If you can go farther, do that. And stretch your legs to the front. So this is called turtle pose or Kurmasana, with your back being the shell of the turtle. Your two hands, two feet are the four limbs of the turtle. Keep sliding your hands to the back, legs to the front. And so now this is a stretch for your lower back. Hold it there. Keep walking your hands back, legs to the front. Stay there. This is a compression for your stomach. Exhale, stomach in. Inhale, relax the stomach. Press all 10 fingernails towards the floor. Breathe. Your palms are facing the sky. And slowly start walking your feet towards you, hands out from underneath position, and slowly come up, sit up tall, stretch out your legs and bring your block between your two feet. Stay at the front edges of your mat. Feet are flexed, legs are active. And if you have your strap, just hold on to that strap. If you don't have a strap, maybe you have a towel. Whatever you have, just lift it up and sit up as tall as you can. Again, keep your arms by your ears. So if you're seeing your arms in the front or with the corners of your eyes, take them more back so they are in line with your hips, in line with your shoulders, all the way up. Stretch your arms up. So give yourself this traction in the spinal column. Keep your arms as close to the ears as possible. So that means don't make a V here. Make them parallel to each other in straight line. Hold it there. Keep sitting up tall. And add a forward fold with your exhale. So you feel the stretch in your hamstrings. And go deeper in the front. If your hands are not by your feet, you may make your strap a bit bigger and then place it around your feet. And pull onto the strap to go forward. Keep going deeper. Breathe. Hold. Look ahead for a second and then go deeper. So draping your upper body over the lower body, minimizing the gap between your chest and your thighs. Hold. Now raise your arms. You put your strap on the side. Bend your knees and slide your hands underneath your thighs. So this time you are hugging the thighs closely, no gap between your chest and thighs. Keeping this connection, slide your legs forward one more time without separating your chest and thighs. If you find they are separating, then you stop at that point. Otherwise, keep going forward as long as you can keep your chest and thighs glued, no gap. Once you reach that max point that you cannot reach any further without separating them, you stop at that point and one more time bring your hands to the front towards your feet. So now your upper body is fully draped over the lower body, no gap. This is a different stretch for your hamstrings. Keep digging your head lower, breathe. So again, compressing your stomach. And slowly come back up, raise your arms one more time, start going down, lower back, middle back, upper back. Take your time as you go down, extend your arms and legs away from the center, remove your block. Point your toes and fingertips away from the center, get that full body stretch. Flex your feet, flex your wrists, separate your toes, separate your fingers. Make your ankle and wrist rotations 3 times one way, 3 times the other way. Let your feet fall off to the corners of the mat. Bring your hands down by your hips, about 8 inches away from your hips. Fingers curl up towards the sky. Nod your head up and down like you're saying yes. Roll your head side to side like you're saying no. Release tension from your neck. Rest your head comfortably in the center. With your eyes closed, starting at the top of your head, establish your intention to relax. Make it a conscious process of letting go of all the thoughts, worries, desires, emotions, stress. Move your awareness through a physical body, one body part at a time, making sure each and every body part is relaxed. Relax your forehead, let go of the wrinkles. Soften your eyebrows, space between eyebrows. Eyes, nostrils, mouth. Put a little smile in your lips. Relax your chin, neck and throat. Soften your shoulders, upper arms, elbows, forearms, palms, fingers and fingertips. Keep your breathing deep, even, slow, quiet, without pauses, without jerks, through your nostrils only. Bring your awareness back up, relax your fingers, palms, wrists, elbows, upper arms, underarms, shoulders. Walk through your body, talk to your body, and listen to your body one body part at a time. Thereby honor, accept, love your body as it is. Honor, accept, love yourself as you are. And honor, accept, love others as they are. Without needing them to change for you in any way. That sets you also free from the need of changing for somebody else. Relax your chest, upper back, lower back, stomach, hips and glutes. A lot of limbering in hips, glutes, thighs today if there's any tension. Still lingering anywhere, visualize it melting away with your exhale, re-energize that area with your inhale. Soften your thighs, hamstrings, knees, backs of your knees, shin bones, calf muscles, ankles, feet and your toes. Complete relaxation. You, your mind and body in total union through your breathing. Slowly bring your awareness back up. Relax your toes, heels, ankles, shin bones, calf muscles, knees, backs of your knees, thighs, hamstrings, hips and glutes, stomach, lower back, upper back. Relax your chest, your shoulders, neck and throat. Soften your facial muscles, chin, cheeks, jaws, eyes, eyebrows, space between eyebrows, forehead and the top of your head. Keeping your awareness there, gently bring your knees in your chest, one at a time, no rush, no jerks. Hug your knees, wiggle your toes, awaken yourself from that relaxed state. Rock your body forward and back, roll it side to side, make knee circles in each direction, or open your legs into a happy baby, or a dead bug, or a big straddle, whichever is right for you, your lower back. You are sitting most of the time today, so if there's any tension in your back, massage your lower back here. I thank you all for joining in this practice. Please thank yourself and everybody here for taking this time out to be here. for sharing positive energy and your practice with everybody. Please join me in sending our goodwill out to the world. May there be peace, happiness, health, love, laughter and freedom to enjoy it all for everybody, everywhere. Roll gently to your right, then to your left. From your left, come up to the sitting upright position and again sit up on the block if you have it. That again allows you to sit up taller. Practice our humming breaths or Bhramari Pranayama. So bring your thumbs to your ears, closing your ears, top two fingers to your eyes, bottom two to your lips. So you're closing all the sensory organs except for your nostrils, and nostrils are open only for breathing, not for sensing or smelling anything. So as you inhale, let the stomach relax and expand. You don't need to push the stomach out, let the incoming air do the job. As you exhale, you draw the stomach in, focus on pulling your stomach in as you hum through your nose. So you focus on that sound. This is your sound meditation. We'll do three of these. Do it at your own pace. We don't need to match or synchronize. Take a deep breath in whenever you're ready. Palms resting in your lap, eyes closed, gaze between eyebrows, awareness either at your diaphragm or your nostrils or your navel center. Wherever you see your breath, just follow your breath in and out. If there are thoughts, let them come and go, just be with your breath. We all breathe in the same air, breathe out the same air, live under the same skies, drink the same water, come from the same earth, go back to the same earth, draw energy from the same sun. We are very much connected through all this. Five basic elements, Pancha Mahabhutas, earth, water, fire, air, sky. And the sixth element is our own life force, our Jivatma. At the core basic level, we are one and the same. It's our karma that keeps separating us. Take this meditative time to go inward, reaching that level of oneness. With your surroundings, the basic elements that make up this world, and with each other. yoga is union of mind, body and breath. It is also union of individual consciousness with universal consciousness by dropping our false ego identities. Finish this practice. Bring your hands behind you, interlace your fingers in the back. Exhale, bow down to Mother Earth for all the kindness. Inhale as you come up to thank the sun for the energy and the light. One more exhale down, being thankful for everything we have and everything we don't have. Inhale up. One last exhale down in gesture of a yogi. Forgive as you go down. Forget as you come up. And we are done. Namaste. Thank you so much. We practice our laughter standing up today because we were sitting most of the time. So just come up to the standing position. And we're going to go from floor to sky with the A sound and then throw the arms up in the air and laugh it out. Laughter is a big exhale. So you start by inhaling. A.